Last Friday was policy committee cutoff, and this Friday is fiscal committee cutoff. Could you explain what these legislative deadlines mean?
Yeah, basically what these deadlines mean, with the policy cutoff, we have that a little bit sooner than we have the fiscal cutoff, because some of the policy bills actually have to be considered in the fiscal committees as well. It's referred to as a re-referral. So they have to get their job done in time for us to be able to take those up in the fiscal committees, and I'm on two of the four fiscal committees. So all we've done this week has been fiscal analysis of either bills that have been directly referred to the committee or bills that have come in out of another committee. And so we've been going through those in the fiscal committees this week. Once we hit that fiscal committee deadline, then we're headed to the floor, and then we'll consider all the bills that originated in the House. The Senate's doing the same thing, and then we'll swap bills and go through the same process again with similar deadlines.
So we can expect a lot of House floor action most of next week then?
Yes, pretty much the whole week and then a little bit into the next week. And that's to meet the deadline to get bills out of the House of Origin. So we'll get those bills out of the House. The Senate is sending bills over to us. As they pass them out of their chamber, they're sending them to us. And then when we get to the cutoff to get our bills out, and the Senate gets to that cutoff, then we start considering each other's bills. So the bills the Senate have sent over to us, we'll start putting those through the committee process, policy committee, and then fiscal committee, and then we'll work on those on the floor later.
Can you give us an update on House Bill 1800, your rural broadband legislation?
Yeah, we talk about how we're at a cutoff on the committees, but if it's a bill that affects state revenues, it actually stays alive until the very end, until we get some of the budget issues worked out. And budgets aren't going to come out for probably another 3 weeks. So you can't really have a cutoff and know that you're going to do all of these bills until you have a feel for what your budget's going to be. And then you start passing the bills that are necessary to implement that budget. In some cases, it can be tax cuts. And sometimes it's changes in spending. Maybe we're increasing spending in one area, decreasing in another, or just increasing it overall. So House Bill 1800, it's not actually dead because it would affect state revenues. So it's one that's still eligible to advance, even though we've gotten past that fiscal deadline.